from Planet Shakers. I know who you are.
No matter what we are going through in our lives, in every season, God is there. Whatever I face, I have hope. When I'm sick, He is my healer. He is my joy. When I don't have much left, He provides. This song is all about the unfailing character of our God. He is the one we can rely on, the one we can depend on, and the one that we worship. I know who you are. I know who you are. Planet Shakers on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine.
From where I'm standing, Lord, it's so hard for me to see where this is going. Where you're leading me, I wish I knew how. All my fears and all my questions are gonna play out in a world I can't control.
Oh, this is your home for best Christian music.
WVYN, Blueford, Wayne City, Fairfield, Mount Vernon.
And now on Translator, W288CO Centralia, broadcasting at 105.5.
A service of Real Life Radio Foundation.
The best Christian music, 90.9 The Vine.
And now, from the 90.9 The Vine newsroom, it's Newsbreak. All the news you need to know from a positive perspective. This news break is made possible by the Medicine Shop Pharmacy in Fairfield. Nearly everyone has a smartphone these days, and there is an app for almost everything. Well, prescription refills are made easy at the Medicine Shop and EdsRx in Fairfield. They have an app that will simplify your life. Drop off your prescription or call it in, and they will text you when your prescription is ready. They even can sync all of your prescriptions together so that your refills will be handled more conveniently for your schedule. Refills made easy at the Medicine Shop Pharmacy and EdsRx in Fairfield.
Welcome to your Wednesday edition of the Vine News Break. I'm Bert McGuire with news that affects you. Physicians assistants James Hopper and Lisa Feather will be staffing Fairfield Memorial Hospital's new urgent care facility. The facility is set to open on November 1st. An open house has been set for Thursday, October 27th from 5 until 8 p.m. Entries are being sought for the annual Fairfield Veterans Day Parade. The event is set for 2 p.m. on Saturday, November 5th. Those interested in participating in the parade should contact parade organizer Clifford Reaver at 516-3111. A celebration of the Wren Lake bypass completion and the final grant payment was held yesterday afternoon. The pipe was vulnerable to breakage in the event of an earthquake, so a grant was located through the Illinois Emergency Management Agency as part of the Multi-Hazard Mitigation Grant Program. The pipe supplies water to about 40,000 people in Jefferson County and the city of Mount Vernon. The Wren Lake College Criminal Justice Roundup for Scholarship event was held last night at the Wren Lake Resort in Whittington. The event raises money for students enrolled in the Criminal Justice Program. Every year, the fundraiser brings in approximately $3,000, enough for at least 6 students to receive financial help for classes in the Criminal Justice Program. This year, 8 students received scholarships after a successful event last year. The Centralia Business and Professional Women's Club Woman of the Year is Marion County Housing Authority Executive Director Allison Austin. The award was announced at a Sunday afternoon Woman of the Year celebration at the First Christian Church by the co-chair of BPW Week Activities, Lorraine Bassett. Austin was honored for her work history with Kaskaskia College, the City of Centralia, and now as Executive Director of the Marion County Housing Authority. If you see news happen or have a news item to submit, please call 895-3030 or email your information to newsbreak@wvyn.org. I'm Brent McGuire, and that's today's Newsbreak on 105.5 and 9.9 The Vine.
90.9 The Vine.
And good morning and welcome back to the Vine Morning Show on this Wednesday morning. I'm Mark. It's great to have you along this morning. Those listening on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. And also, you may be watching right now on our live in-studio camera at WVYN.org, our live in-studio camera on the air right now. Thanks for tuning in as we have a couple of special guests in the studio with me this morning. It's Anna Wilson and Lisa Austin. Ladies, good morning and welcome in this morning.
Good morning.
It's good to see you again, Lisa. You were here a couple of years ago. And Anna, this is your first time here, right?
Yep.
Now, there is something coming up you both are involved in. It is called New Life for Haiti, right?
That's right.
And it's a medical mission trip you guys are getting ready to go on. Anna, tell us a little bit about it, when it's going to happen, and what's in store for when you get over to Haiti.
Well, we're scheduled to leave November 3rd. November 3rd through 10th is when we will scheduled to be gone. Right now, since the hurricane has pretty much destroyed everything where we go, the town is called Marfranc and is in the Grand Anse River Valley, which was the hardest hit area of Hurricane Matthew. So we're trying to figure out logistics of how we can get up there, where we can hold the clinic. The church that the clinic is normally held in has been completely destroyed almost. The roof's gone. Pretty much everything is gone.
Yeah.
So we're trying to figure all that out right now, but we are scheduled to leave in about 2 weeks.
Now, there could be a delay depending on if you're not able to function in the church, right? You may be, maybe push back a little bit, but the trip is still on the schedule,
yeah.
Right?
And it could be the scope of the trip might change a little bit. Right now, everybody's hungry, they're thirsty, so it might go beyond just medical care at this point.
Yeah, you think this was just a couple of weeks ago that Hurricane Matthew hit there.
That's right.
And it devastated, did it totally wipe out a lot of the area there that you're going to be going to?
They say that there's not even any trees left.
Oh, my.
And then we've seen pictures and just trash and devastation like we haven't seen.
Sure, sure. No electricity or nothing there.
Oh, no.
Nothing at all.
There's not that anyway.
Sure, sure. Yeah, yeah. I didn't know if
what they do have is just mainly huts and tin roofs and things like that that are just gone off of their, you know, where they live.
Sure. Now, this is your second time going, Anna,
right? That's right, yeah.
And your first time going, you had no idea what to expect, right?
No. I knew from Lisa and from my mother-in-law, Julie, and from my brother-in-law, Neil, what they had experienced and how it had profoundly changed just how they view things. And I went in thinking that I had a concept of what poverty looked like or what hunger looked like, and I was so wrong.
Mm-hmm.
I was completely blown away by just what I saw, what I experienced, and it really helped bring in a perspective that I wasn't even aware of. A global, you know, reason why we're doing this is, you know, because there is such need out there, and you don't have any clue of really what that is until you see it.
Sure, sure. You know, and we talked off the air that we had a chance to go back in 2011, but situation that happened with us prevented us from going. But if someone's never been on a medical mission trip before or just a mission trip, mm-hmm. you don't know what you're missing. It's an eye-opener. It
yeah.
makes you appreciate what we have here at home.
Yeah.
And but when you prepare for these trips, guys, do you have to have your shots in advance? What's the order of preparing to go on a mission trip like this?
Well, you do have to have your vaccines
mm-hmm.
In order. You have to have your passport in order.
Yeah.
I think you have to spend a lot of time in prayer, honestly, just kind of getting spiritually ready for this kind of trip, because it is something that you can't even try to begin to prepare for yourself. I honestly felt that way myself. Like
mm-hmm.
I was just trying to ask, you know, the Spirit to lead me into what it was that I was supposed to, you know, get out of this trip or why I was being sent there. You know, I felt like I was being called. So I wanted to know kind of, you know, a little bit more about that. You know, I spent a lot of time in prayer leading up to it. And then when I left, I spent more time in prayer just like, what am I supposed to do with this now? Like,
mm-hmm.
how am I supposed to bring this back to the people that I live with and kind of share it and explain it, because I don't know that my words could actually ever do justice to what I experienced there. And Lisa can tell you the same, I'm sure, because it's really hard to describe.
Sure, sure.
Well, I've only been on a medical mission trip with New Life for Haiti, but I do know that on their website
mm-hmm.
there are trips that are available besides just a medical team. There are other teams that go, maybe a team that go help to build or repair. There is an educational team that goes, because New Life for Haiti has also opened some schools there. So there are other opportunities besides medical. They have a website where you can fill out an application, be a part of the team. There is paperwork that's required. And then, as Anna said, you also need to do shots and have your passport. But it's a good place to, if you're interested in going on a medical mission or any kind of a mission trip, that they kind of guide you through those steps
mm-hmm.
and what's needed and keep you safe. It's also about keeping the people that go very safe. New Life for Haiti has a mission house there in Haiti that was built by Fran, the founder of New Life for Haiti. And it is a wonderful facility for missionaries to be able to go. We have some amenities that you're not, you know, that unfortunately the people there don't even have: flushing toilet and showers, even though they're cold showers, but they're showers.
Yeah.
So there are some things, you know, for people that are interested in going on a mission trip.
How many are going this time, Anna?
I think there's 16.
Yeah. 16
of
going
us this time.
Yeah. Four of us from Southern Illinois. myself, Lisa, Julie Wilson, and Jamie Wagner. And we're all connected with SSM hospitals, actually. Mm-hmm. So. Mm-hmm.
Now, when you guys go on these trips like that, do you find out what they need, what they're going to need, and you stock up and take the supplies with you, or do they provide that when you get over there?
We have to take everything. And actually, there are supplies that are shipped before we ever go.
That's what I was leading up to. Are they shipped over before you get over there?
Yeah.
Wow. That's what I think. One of the greatest things about New Life for Haiti, it's a completely, 100% volunteer-led grassroots organization, and they decided to pick one area and decide, how can we help them best? How can we partner with them? Not just give them a handout, but a hand up, and how can we, improve the lives of some people who are in the most remote area in the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere. And they've done that. And, they did that after the earthquake in 2010. And now it feels like almost you have to start all over again with this hurricane. So, I think that the mission really connects with Jesus' mission of, setting the oppressed free. And this area is very oppressed. Mm-hmm. So this is something that, is very passionate to us and to everybody that's connected with New Life for Haiti.
Now, what's the industry? Is there any type of industry over there, guys? You've been before, you've been in it, or that they focus on anything, schooling? Anything like that at all? They have nothing, no resources whatsoever there.
People here will say to me, and have said to me, there's poverty here, Lisa, there's need here in America. Why do you feel like you need to go to Haiti?
Yeah.
And once you've seen it and you've been, you really, it's not even comparable.
Sure.
Our poverty here is, it's like comparing apples and oranges.
Mm-hmm.
It's not comparable. The level of poverty there is literally they have nothing. They will, they live day to day just trying to find food to eat for that day.
Mm-hmm.
They have no resources. They have no government help. It's just to see it. It just touches you in a way you understand how blessed we are here and the resources that we have here. There was one area that I saw had rice stacked up for the people to come, and on the rice bags was stamped USA. And I said I was never so proud to be a farmer's daughter as I was at that moment, that I knew that America was helping. We're helping as much as we can, I think. And and the government there is they don't help their people we do here.
Sure. We're very fortunate here. We just don't realize how blessed we are. And when you go on these medical missions or a mission field such as what you guys are going on, you not only get a chance to go out and help them health-wise, but you get a chance to minister to them about the gospel of Jesus Christ. And do you take Bibles with you? Are you able to take those over with you? Are there restrictions over there in that area, or do you guys know?
There's really not restrictions. The challenge is the language barrier.
Sure.
We don't take Bibles, but we did the year before, we put labels, scriptures, on all of our prescription bags that we handed out, all of the medication that went out. And it was in the language there, just to encourage, just to give some encouragement.
Now, when you go and you have like kind of one-on-one, is there an interpreter that goes along with you and you can understand what they're saying and communicate?
Yes.
Okay, good, good. Yeah, because that's very important.
Each doctor has their own interpreter, and then the nursing staff does as well, so that we can communicate as to what the problem is and how we can best help that patient.
If people want to donate to the trip you guys are going on, is there a way that people can donate financially? Supply wise, how do they do that?
There's several ways actually. You can obviously get a hold of one of us that are going. You can go online to www.newlifeforhaiti.org. And then it'll give you options to donate. You can also text Matthew Relief to 71777. If you go through the website or the text, they will actually give you an email, which you can print out like a tax form mm-hmm. if you need that. Or you can, you know, like I said, just get a hold of one of us, and we will be sending in everything that we can, you know, before the trip, after the trip. This is going to be an ongoing thing, you know, that's going to take a lot of time to, you know, help them rebuild.
Sure, sure. It's one of those where you can't put a time stamp on it because, as you mentioned, Lisa, they have no resources there.
Right.
No heavy equipment, anything
right.
like that.
Yeah.
It's all manual labor, you know, hands-on that you have to do to remove everything.
Right. And I would
have no infrastructure.
Right.
Nothing.
Yeah.
You know, it's just amazing to see it.
Sure,
It is. And I'd like to say also that, you know, if you do decide to donate, 100% of your donation will go towards the people that we serve in the Grand Anse River Valley. You know, and it goes mainly to four areas. One of them would be the seed replanting.
Mm-hmm.
Almost everything green is gone there right now because of this hurricane. So a lot of people depend on their gardens for food, and a lot of farmers are just completely wiped out right now.
Oh,
so number one would be, you know, the seed replanting. Second one would be clean water. Right now, cholera is killing many people down there, and that might just get worse, you know, as the weeks and months, you know, continue to go. So clean water project would be the second area where your money would go to. The third would be home rebuilding. Most of the reports you see on TV, you know, houses are reduced to rubble, matchsticks, you know, almost all the roofs are gone. So it's just it's a true humanitarian crisis right
sure,
now.
Sure, sure, sure.
And then the fourth area would be the medical care, which we are involved with.
Can you guys come back in just a little bit, talk a little more? Okay, we're talking with Anna Wilson and Lisa Austin this morning about New Life for Haiti. And we're going to come back here in just a few moments. We'll take a short break and come back and talk more with the ladies about New Life for Haiti when we return in just a few moments. Time now for Max Hooper, A Moment in God's Word. It's underwritten this morning by Crawford Plumbing, and they're located in Woodlawn.
Crawford Plumbing, LLC in Woodlawn is licensed, bonded, insured, and ready to serve your household and business plumbing needs. From leaky faucets to complete plumbing systems and repair, Crawford Plumbing in Woodlawn is a full-service plumbing company. They can be reached at 618-242-3360. Crawford Plumbing in Woodlawn is a proud underwriting sponsor of Real Life Radio.
It's time now for A Moment in God's Word with your host, Max Hooper.
Hello, everyone. Now, through God's Word, He teaches us about perseverance. One of the sticking parts of Scripture is when God tells us that because we show faith in Him, we will encounter difficulties. I could never quite understand this until I realized that there are forces that resist the truth. We all resist truth on occasions. You'll be amazed, just through force of habit, when this occurs. However, God knew that His disciples would encounter resistance while spreading His word. I guess that's one reason I place so much trust in God. When evil forces go to such extremes to speak against His word, I know that God's word is truth. Truth is found everywhere in Scripture. However, the evil world does just what God said they would do in Matthew 10:22. All men will hate you because of men, but he who stands firm to the end will be saved. God gives us unending lessons about perseverance. Romans 5:3-4. Not only so, but we also rejoice in our sufferings because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance character, and character hope. We have seen these things in our simple life, staying with our belief and working to a successful end, staying with our tasks against what seemed impossible odds, having faith in our children when we were at a loss, as to the outcome, but praying to God for His help. Perseverance always means hard work, no matter if it's preparing for the big game, getting ready for a job interview, professing your faith in Jesus before friends and neighbors, facing job loss with limited funds. But God has been with us all the way. We are surrounded by believers who are there to help and comfort us He tells us in Hebrews 12:1, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by such great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles. Let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us." Have you given much thought recently to those believers that stand ready to be at your side? Don't ever forget you are surrounded with God's children. Perseverance. Stay with it. Stay in God's Word, knowing that He is by your side to encourage you to endure life's sufferings in faithfulness to Him. Do not turn away from the truth of His Word. Thanks for being with us today. This is Max Hooper. Have a great day.
You've been listening to A Moment in God's Word, a daily devotion hosted by Southern Illinois sports legend, Max Hooper.
Me and my friends love the Vine.
90.9 The Vine.
There was a time I was dead inside. You called my name and I tried to hide. My heart was dark and so full of shame, full of shame. But like the dawning of a brand new day, your love has chased my shame away.
From the group Pocket Full of Rocks here at Real Life Radio 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. Their song called Alive. It is 8:24. And we welcome you back to the Vine Morning Show. Those of you listening on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, if you're watching through our website at wvyn.org, thanks for tuning in this morning as we're with Anna Wilson and Lisa Austin this morning with New Life for Haiti. And ladies, we were talking off the air just about poverty that Haiti lives through yearly, and the devastation through right now through the earthquakes they've had over there, and now recently through Hurricane Matthew. And Lisa, you told me something that just really I about fell out of the chair when you told me that. You know, we think of our income here that we make in our jobs and our daily work of life. You know, sometimes people feel like they're underpaid, that they don't make enough to survive. But when you gave me that figure a while ago, it's like, you know, it's nothing. We have nothing to complain about because they don't make nothing over there in Haiti because there's no industry. It's all little things they pick up that they do to make money. And what do they make a year? What was that figure again?
Incomparable to our income here, they survive on $300 of American money in a year per annually.
$300. Wow, that's just unreal. And we think we have it bad here. Yeah, when we look at, okay, our wages and stuff in the United States, $300 yearly. That's a week's worth of groceries for most families. It's just something else. And everyone over there, there's no concrete. You were mentioning you had to go over there. They have to build, you know, foundations for these buildings that are put up, constructed, because everything's constructed and they live on dirt, right?
That's correct.
My, oh my. What is the, we were talking about the religion over there. It's a mixture. It's, you know, it's, you mentioned what?
They have Catholics.
Catholic.
There are the church that we set up in for the medical team is Baptist.
Mm-hmm.
There's voodoo there. Mm. They practice voodoo. Not all of the Haitians, but there are some that do. So it's a mixture of a lot of different faiths.
Sure. It's just one of those deals where, again, if you've never been on a mission trip, people are highly encouraged to go, right?
Absolutely.
And if someone comes and they're listening right now and they say, I want to go on that mission trip, it's really too late to do that now. But there are other mission trips you can go on, and there's a way you can find that out, right?
That's correct. This one is closed. Mm-hmm. But there are other mission trips listed on the website. If you go on, click on it, it'll tell about it, tells what we do. You can fill out an application and go in the future, on future mission trips.
Yeah, and those range from education to building homes to clean water projects to seed replanting, medical missions. There's a variety of ways that you can serve down there.
And you guys are going, and Lisa, you'll be doing, there'll be surgeries performed, there'll be medical checkups. What else will happen when
you guys leave? Well, every year that we've went, the number of the Haitian people that we serve has continued to increase.
Mm-hmm.
Last year, we served about 630 people. And performed 20 surgeries. The year before, we served about 580, did 18 surgeries. So you can see every year it continues. And when I say that we perform surgeries, we literally have a person just on like a kitchen table.
No sterilization whatsoever,
well,
other
we,
than
as
what
we can.
You
as sterile as,
sterile as,
we,
you
as
can.
We possibly can get it.
Yeah.
We bring the supplies and we try to make it as sterile and as close as we can get to what we have here.
Yeah,
it's very challenging.
Sure. And long days you guys put in when you go on these. You're not, it's just not like a 7 to 3 or an 8 to 5.
You go all day,
right?
All day. And into the night.
Into the night. And sometimes hours where you think, when's it going to end, you know? And you guys, what's the accommodations for when you go on these trips like that? Do you have to sleep on the dirt floor? Are you put up somewhere to where, you know, you can get some rest? Or how does that work for anyone that volunteers usually?
Well, we do have the mission house, as I said.
Sure.
That we have beds in the mission house, and like I said, flushing toilets and a shower. So we do have some amenities that people can come and at least feel comfortable as best that it can be in a situation, mm-hmm. you know,
yeah.
in Haiti. So.
And Anna, when you go, what one thing that you will be doing over there when you're there?
Well, I'm a pharmacy technician here, so actually that's what I do there. And I love how God kind of presents opportunities for you to just use what you can with, you know, with where he's going to send you. So I'll be in the medical clinic just passing out meds. I organize the medications. We usually give out a year's supply of some of the blood pressure medications that we give out. We see a variety of things in the clinics, everything that you would see here, honestly. There's a lot of antibiotics that need to be gone out. There's a lot of rashes and fungal infections and bacterial infections and, you know, a lot of injuries. And even more so now, I'm assuming, since, you know, this hurricane has hit. And, you know, as Lisa said, we see, you know, more and more people every year. Well, there's probably an infinite amount of people we could see this time. So
sure, and that's ranging to babies even.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Lots
of
babies.
Lots of babies.
Sometimes it's very difficult and frustrating whenever you want to do more and you know the technology is there. Mm-hmm. And you know if we just had what we have here at home. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We could, but we're limited on
sure.
what we do. So we do the best that we can do with what we have.
Sure.
And that's what God's calling us
Amen.
To do.
Amen.
Is to do all we can do
all
with what we have, where we're at.
Sure.
Wherever that is, wherever sure. He's calling us to.
Sure. And not only that, but you get a chance to pray for these families too.
Absolutely.
Right? Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And this year I wanted to do something different with the children. I wanted to have a campfire service
mm-hmm.
where we sing some songs mm-hmm. and we teach them some songs to do something fun for the kids. And I think after this hurricane, one evening of that would be just to have an evening of relief and break and joy mm-hmm. for these children
yeah.
would
yeah.
be so awesome. So that's kind of my plan. And I would like to take popcorn. They've
sure.
never had anything like that. I don't know if I'll
yeah.
be able to do that, but
yeah.
And just to have just a fun night with singing around a fire and some popcorn, and I don't, you know.
That would be so cool. Maybe you can have that shipped over there or something, you know. Man, that would be so neat. If they've never experienced
never had anything
like
that,
that
you
before.
Know, and just have a fun time for the kids.
Sure.
To give them a break from their life.
Wow. Yeah. And to see them smile.
Yes.
I'm sure when you guys get there, they may be depressed, but when they see you arrive, it's just instant smiles because they know you're their relief. You're their, at that point in time, you're their healer.
Yeah.
And you're going to be able to do some things, as you say, it's limited, but there's so many things you're going to be able to do that they've not experienced, right?
Right.
The children will a lot of times point to you and yell the word blanc, blanc, which means white.
Mm-hmm.
And their parents will have them to touch you. Some have this superstition that we bring them luck.
Mm-hmm.
And so they, and you just love on them.
You just love on them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Now, once you leave and you come back into the United States, do you follow up with how things are going
absolutely.
Over there? Are you able to follow
yes,
up and
absolutely.
Find out?
There is one nurse in the village to serve all these people.
Sure.
And we try to make sure that she has supplies that she needs for our follow-up surgeries and that, and any supplies that we can send her
mm-hmm.
to help treat the patients there in the village
mm-hmm.
throughout the year.
Mm-hmm.
But that's their only medical resource is this
yeah.
one nurse.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I remember you told you were here a couple of years ago or so in that time frame, and you told about the wheelchair, the young man in the wheelchair and everything, and that you were able to get the wheelchair over to him. And
Anna actually had worked for a DME company at mm-hmm. that time, and she was able to get the wheelchair ordered through the DME company, and Julie and I had it sent to Haiti. Felix, who oversees our mission house, got it picked up for this person who is a boy that I sponsor, and he has club feet. And I was able to go to his home and see where he lived, and the last time I was there, and to see the wheelchair and to see it in use. You don't see those kinds of things in Haiti.
Yeah.
There is no, there's no bicycles, there's no wheelchairs, there's nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So to see that, and he was able at least to get around, it just brought joy to my heart.
Sure.
It was very emotional for me.
Sure, sure. Wow, wow. Again, if people need information, what's the website they can go and can they call? How
yeah.
can they get a hold?
Well, they can get a hold of us, like I said. You can go to the website, which is www.newlifeforhaiti.org, And you can also text the word Matthew Relief to 71777. And we would be happy to, you know, come if, you know, there, I think there's a lot of people who want to help but just don't know how. So if you'd like for, you know, one of us to come to your club, your youth group, your church, your civic organization, whatever, we would love to do that. We would love to, you know, help share what we do down there and how you can help, because there's an infinite need, like we said earlier, and there's plenty of opportunities.
How can people get a hold of you guys? If someone wants to get a hold of you, say, I want to come, I want to know more. How can they get a hold of you?
Well, you can go through, you can, I'll give you my phone number. It's 231-6479, you know, and it's,
and mine is 618-895-4725.
Yeah. Or you can get a hold of, you know, my church is Fouts Christian Church. They'll be able to get a hold of me anytime. Mm-hmm. We are a partner church with New Life for Haiti.
Sure.
So
and
we would love.
And our churches too, as well.
Okay, and what's your church, Lisa?
The Springerton Community of Christ.
Okay, in Springerton. All right. Hey, good luck. God bless your trip. Hopefully you'll be able to go, and if not, you'll be pushed back a little bit, but it is a definite trip to go.
Yes.
Enjoy it. I know you guys will. I know this is something that's close to your heart.
Yeah.
Keep me posted on that, all right?
Mark, I want to thank you,
sure,
so
no
much
problem.
For allowing us to come in and talk about our beloved
sure,
friends
sure.
in Haiti and the people there. Thank you for the opportunity to share this with those that listen.
Sure.
And for those that are listening, thank you for just hearing what we have to say today. And
sure.
I just pray God will touch your heart and bless you as you reach out to whoever. Like I said, doing with what we have wherever we're at.
Sure, right. sure. And if you can send some pictures, send me some of those pictures, and
sure.
I'll be glad to post them on our Facebook page,
great.
Too.
Thank you.
Because I think people need to see visually
yes.
what you guys are doing before it really... And I know it has an effect on them now, but it'll even have a more effect on their life once they see
yes.
what you guys are experiencing and having your hands in.
Well, if they would like for us to come even to their church or mm-hmm. Like Anna said, any place, we do have like a slide presentation
sure.
that shows what we do in the clinic.
Right.
It actually shows us in the presentation.
Yeah.
So,
wow. Yeah, that'd be awesome to see too. Yeah. All right. Good luck, ladies.
Thank you.
God
much.
Bless
thank
you guys you, and God bless your trip, you know, okay?
Yes.
Keep in touch and keep me posted, all
I
right?
I would like for your listeners to
sure.
pray for us.
Yeah. Yes.
Pray
yeah.
for our safety and our protection of health as we travel.
Yeah.
And especially after the hurricanes has come through, it's so much more challenging for
yeah.
our team.
Yeah.
So please keep us in your prayers.
We will.
We covet those very much.
Yeah, we will. We'll do that. All right.
Thank you.
All right. Anna, Lisa, thanks for coming in this morning. It's been awesome. New Life for Haiti. They told you how you can get involved as well. And we'll come back here in just a little bit, talk more on the Vine Morning Show. We have sports on the way and much more for you on this Wednesday. More to come from Real Life Radio.
Real Life Radio is thankful for the financial partnership we have with Greenwald & Sons Construction in Wayne City and in Mount Vernon. They specialize in residential and commercial construction and remodeling. They have a long list of satisfied customers spanning over 38 years. Whether it's a church addition, business expansion, or new home construction, Greenwald & Sons Construction of Wayne City and Mount Vernon are experts that you can depend on. Their phone number is 895-2044. And we thank them for their support of local Christian radio.
Hi, this is Ken Gordon, worship leader at Christian Fellowship Church in Mount Vernon. At CFC, it is our desire to see men and women become true disciples of our Lord Jesus Christ. On Sunday, we have adult Bible study and Sunday school for children at 9 a.m., followed by worship at 10. For more information, please visit our website at mvcfc.org or call us at 244-7466. Please join us at Christian Fellowship Church, where every member is a minister.
Christian music and programming on The Vine is made possible by Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service in Mount Vernon. Located at 1321 South 10th Street in Mount Vernon, Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service offers customer service the way it should be and is 100% locally owned and operated. With ASE certified mechanics, Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service is committed to your complete auto care satisfaction. Their phone number is 315-6497, and we are thankful for their support.
The following is a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had numerous credit cards, and I was struggling with paying them off, so I made the call.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-606-4000. 4260.
The people at Trinity are very friendly. They will do whatever you need them to do in order for you to feel better about being in a very difficult place.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-606-4260.
Hi, this is Ashley DeVoy with the Fairfield Banking Company. We've been strongly rooted in this area since 1892. Our foundation is strong, and we offer a unique checking account for customers 50 and older. It's called the 1892 Founders Club Checking, and it puts your money to work with interest paid on balances of $1,000 or more. You've worked hard to build a strong financial foundation for yourself, and now it's time to reap the rewards, including free checks and paper statements. Learn more about the 1892 Founders Club Checking account available at the Fairfield Banking Company, 915 Commerce Drive, member FDIC, and equal housing lender.
With a practical look at doing what's right with your money, here's Howard Dayton with today's question. Hey Howard, I'm 22 and will be graduating from college soon with $25,000 of student loans. What should I do to prepare for retirement?
Wow, I'm impressed that you're planning for retirement this far ahead. Well, the key is to follow the Compass Money Map. On the map, there are seven destinations on the journey to true financial freedom, and the map helps you understand where you are financially, where you want to go financially, and enables you to focus on the next thing to accomplish to become financially healthier. In your case, you first want to pay off your student loans and then begin to invest for your future. Now, if you want a copy of the Compass Money Map, just go to heyhoward.org and download it. It's free. That's heyhoward.org.
Good morning, everyone. Time now to check sports on this Wednesday morning. Girls high school volleyball action last night. Mount Vernon Rams defeated Wayne City 2-1. North City Omaha infield over Fairfield Lady Mules 2-1. Carmi White County beat Grayville 2-0. It was Chester beating Christopher 2-1. Sisney defeated North Clay 2-0. Edwards County beat Hamilton County 2-1. Effingham beat Salem 2-0. Marion over Carbondale 2-1. Marissa beat Lebanon 2-0. Mascoutah over Civic Memorial 2-0. Murfreesboro winner over West Frankfort 2-0. Oakville defeated Christ Our Savior Lutheran 2-0. Robinson over Tutopolis 2-1. Cesar Valier Waltonville over El Dorado in 2 games. Sparta defeated Carterville in 2 games. And Thompsonville beat Gallatin County in 2 games in girls high school volleyball action last night. Boys soccer, the Class 1A sectionals at Waterloo-Jabot. Waterloo-Jabot beat Breeze Central 3-0 in Altoff over Mater Dei 4-0. The Class 3A regionals in Granite City, it was Edwardsville beating Granite City 5-0. Collinsville over Alton 4-1. In O'Fallon, Quincy beat Belleville East 4-1. And O'Fallon over Belleville West. Final score, O'Fallon 4, Belleville West 2. Junior high boys basketball action last night. Wayne City got a win over Bluford. Final score, Wayne City 34, Bluford 28. Girls junior high basketball. Sisney beat Fairfield 18-14, and Jasper beat Wayne City last night 39-36. Major League Baseball action from yesterday. Well, the Toronto Blue Jays were on the verge of elimination in the ALCS, but they won yesterday afternoon, beating Cleveland. It was Toronto 5, Cleveland 1. Now, the Indians lead that series 3-1. They still lead that series, and they'll play again this afternoon, 3:08 game time in Toronto. It'll be Cleveland and Toronto. Indians leading that series 3-1. Now, last night in Los Angeles, the Cubs and the Dodgers played. The Cubs are struggling right now. Their offense is just not going. And last night, the Dodgers beat the Cubs 6-0. And the Dodgers lead that series 2-1. Now the Cubs and the Dodgers play again tonight, 7:08 in Los Angeles. Again, the Dodgers leading that series 2-1. NBA basketball action last night. It was Washington beating Cleveland 96-91. Atlanta beat New Orleans 96-89. It was Miami beating Orlando 107-77. Oklahoma City over Denver 97-87. And the LA Clippers beat Sacramento 92-89. National Hockey League from last night. The Blues and Vancouver played in Vancouver last night, and Vancouver beat the Blues in overtime 2-1. Chicago beat Philadelphia 7-4. New Jersey beat Anaheim 2-1. San Jose over the New York Islanders 3-2. Washington over Colorado 3-0. Montreal beat Pittsburgh 4-0. Ottawa over Arizona 7-4. In a shootout last night, it was Tampa Bay beating Florida 4-3. Dallas beat Nashville 2-1. Minnesota 6, Los Angeles 3. In overtime, Calgary beat Buffalo. Calgary 4, Buffalo 3. And Edmonton over Carolina last night. Final score, Edmonton 3 and Carolina 2. And that is a check of sports for you on this Wednesday morning. I'm Mark Wells reporting.
What do you do on Wednesday nights? Here at Orchardville Church, we have a lot going on. We have something for all ages. We have nurseries, pre-K through fifth grade, an awesome youth group, which includes junior and senior high ages. And for the adults, we have music, praying, teachings, and testimonies of what God has done. Come and get a midweek boost. You'll be glad you did. Services begin at 7 p.m. Like us on Facebook or visit us at orchardvillechurch.com.
How great is God's amazing grace.
Time now to check the area weather forecast being underwritten by Home Source Warehouse in there in Mount Vernon.
Monthly financial support of local Christian radio is provided by Home Source Warehouse in Mount Vernon. Located 4 miles north of Mount Vernon on Route 37, Home Source Warehouse offers a warehouse full of quality furniture and mattresses with legendary service. Open Thursday and Friday 10 to 6, Saturday 10 to 3. You can find them on Facebook, and their website is homesourcewarehouse.net. Their phone number is 204-5515. Home Source Warehouse, where style is affordable.
Southern Illinois weather.
Well, the forecast for the Vine listening area on this Wednesday. Thunderstorms are likely today. Now, a few of these storms that we'll experience a little bit later on today may be severe. We'll have a high of 74. Yeah, you know, stop and think about severe thunderstorms in the month of October. Not at all. Chance of rain for tomorrow as well, only a high of 61, then clear skies on Friday with a high of 60. Right now in the area, Salem 67, Benton 72, Carmi 70, in Wayne City right now it is 70. Here's Lincoln Brewster, his song called Oxygen. It's coming up next right here at the Vine.
90.9 The Vine.
Your hands.
than oxygen.
To Real Life Radio.
Music that might freak out Grandma.
Till she hears the words.
What do you have to say?
Assuming Grandma can hear the words.
Good music never sounded so
good. 105.5 and 90.9, The Vine.
I have loved you from the start. I have seen your hurting heart. And you feel so lonely, but you keep on hiding, 'cause you feel so guilty for what you've done. But there's no distance too far that I can't reach you. There's no place that's so dark that I can't find you. Anywhere that you are, if you need proof, take a look at these scars. I know I love you.
and you feel so dirty. You know you're unworthy, feeling undeserving.
Music and ministry that is always uplifting and encouraging. Local Christian Radio, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, never too far gone. That is Jordan Feliz as we're heading into 9 o'clock. We'll have another interview coming up for you just after 9 this morning. It'll be Robert Koker from Fairfield, as Robert's going to talk about a Fairfield area prayer meeting that is coming up on Friday, and it will be October 28th, all right? And we'll talk with Robert just after the 9 o'clock hour. Right here on the Vine Morning Show. Stay tuned. Right now, Jeremy Camp, Come Alive, right here at the Vine.
As I watch the world being held captive by dreams that will never be fulfilled in this life, chasing the darkness and everything that surrounds, all the emptiness buried inside, well, I won't stop showing this hope that is holding the passion so deep in my heart, to tell all the world of your love and affection and the plan that you've had from the start. So I will continue to fight till the world comes alive, till the world comes alive. All the broken and bleeding just start by believing His love has conquered His call. So I will continue to fight till the world comes alive, till the world comes alive, yeah. 'Cause you have restored us and you have redeemed us. We have been
that will never be fulfilled in this life.
This is your home for best Christian music.
WVYN, Blueford, Wayne City, Fairfield, Mount Vernon.
And now on Translator, W288CO Centralia, broadcasting at 105.5.
A service of Real Life Radio Foundation.
The best Christian music, 90.9 The Vine.
I can see the tears filling your eyes, and I know where they're coming from. They're coming from a heart that's broken in two by what you don't see. The person in the mirror doesn't look like the magazine. Oh, but when I look at you, it's clear to me.
Stephen Curtis Chapman from Real Life Radio, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, Fingerprints of God. Time right now for Uncommon Moments with Tony Dungy, and it's underwritten by Fairfield National Bank.
As a financial advisor, John Reynolds is well-versed in the best practices of financial planning. But as a local, raised in Wayne County, he's more than experienced with the unique challenges you face every day. After growing up here, he's now returned, investing back into the community that contributed to his success. Passionate, and committed to helping you with yours. FNB Asset Management. We're here to help.
What does it take to live an uncommon life? Here's former Super Bowl winning coach Tony Dungy with today's uncommon moment.
Have you ever asked yourself what your purpose in life is? Well, for me, it's touching lives, building a legacy not necessarily on the football field, but in those places that most people will never see, trying to be faithful in the position God has given me. I love coaching football, and winning a Super Bowl was a goal I've had for a long time, but it has never been my purpose in life. My purpose in life is simply to glorify God. I coach football, but the good I can do to glorify God along the way is my real purpose. I want to help people see the path to eternal life through Christ. We are all role models to someone in this world.
Tony Dungy, author of the popular Uncommon book series. Discover more at CoachDungy.com. That's CoachDungy.com.
And good morning and welcome back to the Vine Morning Show. Those listening in on 105.5 and also 90.9 The Vine. If you're watching on our live in-studio camera this morning on our website, wvyn.org, we welcome you and thanks for tuning in this morning as I have another special guest in the studio with me. And his first time being here at The Vine, we welcome Robert Koker from Fairfield. Robert, good morning, my friend, and it's nice to see you and welcome in this morning.
Good morning, Mark. Thank you.
Now, you have an event coming up, and that is it's called One Cry, and it's a Fairfield area prayer meeting. Tell us a little bit about it. How did it come about? And give us the details about it.
Okay. I'll give you a little bit of a backstory here. I've been part of a group that's been praying for our area for a long time now in Sisney. For over 10 years now, on Saturday nights, we pray. We pray for the church, we pray for pastors, we pray for the nation. And as a natural outreach of that group, we decided to begin to launch that same meeting as a monthly meeting in Fairfield. And so in July of 2011, we began to hold monthly prayer meetings that were community-based, inviting pastors, inviting churches. And since then, we've been doing those, and we have moved those from a central location where we used to meet to now we're moving them out into the churches. The churches are going to be hosting these meetings once a month going forward.
And, you know, when you stop and think about that, that's been a long time ago in 2011, and now you're just growing and getting bigger now. And it's so important, Robert, that this event is taking place and it's growing because we need prayer. Our country needs prayer right now. We as Christians, as churches, and as America, we need to wake up. We need to be in prayer more often than what we are. Wouldn't you agree with that?
The need is desperate, and it is urgent. Tonight on television, some will be able to, and some won't be able to find the stomach to watch the final presidential debate before our election, which is less than 3 weeks away. And it is plain and is obvious to any seeking Christian that we are in desperate need of prayer in our nation. We see this locally as well. And so we're very happy to be part of what God is doing. It's one small part, but we believe it's an important part of what the Lord is doing in our region and in our nation.
And tell us about, and now, this is all a part of One Cry, and it's a nationwide call for spiritual awakening.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about One Cry. How did you find out about it? And give us a little bit of history about it.
Very interesting, Mark, because we actually began these prayer meetings and we're calling them One Cry before we ever heard about an organization called One Cry.
Wow.
That was started the following February. So it was a natural fit for us. There is no official membership or adherence to a particular church or ministry. They are simply a group of people. It was born out of the Life Action Ministries that travels all over the nation, encouraging churches towards prayer. And we hooked up with their name, and by permission, we use their name and we use their materials. If I may, I will read their statement from their website,
sure.
OneCry.com. One Cry is a nationwide call for spiritual awakening, a movement of believers urgently crying out to God to revive the church and transform the culture. One Cry is a movement of like-minded people, churches, and organizations who agree that our nation needs a dramatic turnaround. And One Cry is a resource center that provides the tools to help your church, your Sunday school class, or small group, or friends to seek God in prayer and repentance and collective action. Organizations, programs, and events have not brought the spiritual transformation we need personally or in our families and our neighborhoods. Politics, education, and economic prosperity will not revive the soul of our nation. But what might happen if thousands of prayer warriors pled with God for spiritual awakening? What if voices in communities across the nation were raised to share revival truth? What if leaders called on the world for spiritual renewal? What if believers everywhere earnestly sought the manifested presence of God? And what if God heard from heaven and healed our land? That is our one cry.
Mm. Wow. It's amazing that you guys, that's what you called it. And then this came about just a year later, right?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, what will take place? Now, the next area prayer meeting is coming up on Friday, October 28th. What will happen? Just give us a brief rundown. What will happen that day? Everyone will meet, and then
yes, one of our chief goals going forward is to have the host pastor of the church and as many other local pastors as can help us to be the prayer leaders of the meeting.
Mm-hmm.
We follow a model, Mark, where we intersperse the prayer and times of worship. We believe it should be one flow, just as it is in the throne room of God, where we see prayer of intercession with Jesus, our great high priest, whoever lives to make intercession for us, and the 24/7 worship of God. Those things are always going on in his throne room in the temple in heaven. And we want to follow that model. So we mix worship and prayer together for about an hour. Lord willing, sometimes it goes a little bit more, but we try to respect everyone's time. But we believe that this is a close following of the kind of the model that even David used in the tabernacle in his time, where he had priests and singers in the tabernacle 24/7. And so we try to follow that model, and we strongly encourage multi-church participation. We want this to be a movement that is not about any one ministry or any one church or any one organization, but the whole church, the whole body of Christ in the Fairfield area.
Yeah, and it's to gather everyone together.
Yes.
And where will it be coming up on Friday, October 28th?
It will be at the Fairfield First General Baptist Church. Pastor Kyle Sessions, a great man of God. I believe you've had him on the air here mm-hmm. on the Vine before. And he'll be hosting the meeting that night and opening the meeting for us. And we look forward. I have a history with that church as well. I pastored there for 4 years, from 1996 to 2000. Great group of people there that we love dearly. And so we're real happy to be taking the mobile prayer meeting to that venue next week.
And this is something that you will have. Is it once a month that you will do this, Robert?
That's right.
Right. Once a month. And you yes. just rotate from any of the churches that want to participate, right?
Yes. And we'll be making available the roster of churches that will be participating in 2017. By the end of this year, we'll have that prepared. Already have at least a half a dozen pastors who have gotten on board and said, we want to be part of this. We want our churches to host them. And we're excited about that.
Yeah, that's awesome. Now, is it strictly just for the fair? Is it anywhere in Wayne County? Is it just any county that wants to come and be a part of it?
Anyone can be part of it, Mark. And we're very encouraged that we're hearing of other similar prayer meetings that are springing up all over our area. I got to be part of one in Sisney last week. There's one coming up in Crossville and Iuka, all through that area. Some of them are weekly, some of them are monthly. I heard of one that's going to be happening two nights in a row. These things are springing up everywhere, mm-hmm. and we believe it's a sovereign move of God on behalf of our nation.
Amen. I agree with that. We'll come back here in a moment and talk more with Robert Koker. And Robert's the associate pastor of New Beginnings Church in
yes.
Fairfield. We're going to come back and talk more with Robert about the One Cry, the area prayer meeting coming to Fairfield on Friday, October 28th. And we'll be back and talk more with Robert when we come back here on the Vine Morning Show. Right now it's time for Voice of the Martyrs, and it's underwritten this morning by the Tin Shed. They're located in Wayne City. 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine is thankful for the underwriting support of the Tin Shed in Wayne City. They are your source for primitive, country, and home decor in a wide selection to meet your decorating needs. The Tin Shed is located at 701 West Robinson in Wayne City, and their phone number is 895-2155.
Hi, I'm Todd Nettleton, and this is Voice of the Martyrs Radio. As Islamic terrorists swarmed over her Indonesian village, Dolores, a frail 78-year-old believer, was forced to run for her life, except that she could barely walk. Miraculously, she escaped. That's not a worry for most aging parents and grandparents. Most can live out their lives in relative peace without any fear of persecution for their Christian faith. But in Indonesia, a country where Christians and Muslims used to peacefully coexist, people like Dolores live in daily fear. A call to jihad is forcing Christians, including the most vulnerable, to flee from their homes. Will you remember to pray for Dolores' protection and provision and thousands in Indonesia who suffer for their faith?
I will not let my brothers and sisters suffer in silence, nor will I let them serve alone. To join me in prayer for persecuted Christians, go to vomradio.net.
Positive music, positive interviews, and great daily devotionals. It's positively tremendous.
90.9 The Vine.
They say what you see is what you get. There's more to life than meets the eye. They don't believe what they don't understand. I've touched your hands, I've felt your side. Enough to whisper, to hear my cry. In the light of morning, in the dead of night, I see you standing in the window.
Music and ministry that helps you connect with God. It is local Christian radio, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. That's from the group Leland, their song called Invisible. And we welcome you back to the Vine Morning Show. Here we are on this Wednesday morning. We welcome those listening in on 105.5 and also 90.9 The Vine. And also watching on our website at wvyn.org, our live in-studio cameras. We're video streaming live this morning as I have a special guest in the studio with me. It's Associate Pastor Robert Koker from New Beginnings Church in Fairfield. And Robert, good morning, and thanks again for coming on and talking a little bit about One Cry this morning.
Thank you, Mark.
You know, we were talking off the air just a few moments ago, and this is sort of reminding me of how old-fashioned tent revivals used to go many years ago, and in fact, they still happen across the area. But this is kind of reminding me of that. Yes. This is starting up, and you're just bringing anybody, any church together, all denominations together, to pray to God. And yes, you know, it's so vital. Prayer is so vital, Robert. And you've got an interesting statistic that happened many years ago in New York, right?
Well, we believe that this kind of praying should be done in the revival spirit and tradition. Our country has gone through several cycles of difficulty and spiritual coldness, as it were. There was a man in New York City named Jeremiah Lanfear. He worked for the Dutch Reformed Church there as a outreach missionary. And the church was discouraged because many of the churches in that part of the city were closing because the business sector was encroaching there and people were moving into the outlying boroughs. And as Jeremiah was walking through the city, he became burdened to pray and to ask others to pray with him. So he advertised a prayer meeting that was going to happen at the church. And on September 23rd, 1857, he opened the doors of the church to this prayer meeting. And it was supposed to be from 12 noon to 1 o'clock. And it was inviting all of the local businessmen that worked in that area and anyone else who would come. And he sat there for 30 minutes by himself until he heard some footsteps, and one man came and then another. And by the time they finished, they had six people at that first prayer meeting. The second week, they had 20. The next week, they had 40. And that same week, the financial crisis hit that was the precursor to great difficulty in our nation, also followed by the Civil War. That prayer meeting spread and grew into the tens and to the hundreds of thousands of people, not only in New York, but in many cities across the nation. And it is estimated that somewhere between 300,000 and a million converts happened because of the revival that grew out of a simple prayer meeting that one man started in one city in 1857.
Wow. Wow. Amen.
And we're asking the Lord for something similar in our nation today.
Wow. And it all began with just six people. The first in attendance.
Six.
Six people. My goodness.
So how many does it take is our question. You know, the
sure.
Lord says, if any two of you shall agree as touching anything on earth, it'll be done by my Father in heaven.
Mm-hmm.
And so if we're in agreement with the Lord and we're in agreement with each other, the number's not as important as to whether we're in agreement with what God is doing.
Amen. You know, something else, Robert, we discussed this off the air, and you probably have seen and heard. I've seen and heard churches nationwide, churches in the area. Some are just really—they don't know where to go now. They're giving up. They're struggling. Some doors are closing. People
yes.
are diminishing in their church. And you know, this is another reason why this is so good for churches to regain their composure, come together. And let's pray together,
yes.
And let's not let that door close on that church.
Amen. Especially here in Illinois, I'll give you another anecdotal example of something that's happening currently, today as a matter of fact. As a result of being in Springfield, Illinois earlier this year and part of Franklin Graham's
yes.
Awake America meeting, I got to meet a gentleman from the Peoria area who is also a pastor, who he says the Lord asked him to pray through every county in Illinois prior to the election this year. And today, this day, he is finishing the final three counties in Illinois that he and his team are praying through. He came to Wayne County, to the Wayne County Courthouse, earlier in the year, in the summertime, And we were able to lead a contingency of people that came and helped him pray on the courthouse lawn for our city, our county, our state, and our nation. And Mark, this really is the hope of churches that are suffering, that are struggling. It is indicative of the spiritual condition of the church nationwide. And I'm not talking about every pastor, every church that's listening to us this morning. I've been blessed to meet and fellowship with and pray with some great and some awesome pastors and churches. But overall, we are suffering decline. George Barna, the statistician for the church, estimates that over 1,000 pastors a month are leaving the ministry. They're walking away from ministry. Churches are closing, as you said. We are in desperate need of a great spiritual revival.
And you know, a lot of pastors, Robert, are part-time, a lot are full-time. Is it from both sides, or is it one side that's being more the ones that are leaving the ministry?
I don't have the statistics on that. All yeah. I can tell you is that, like myself as a bivocational pastor,
sure.
That there's a lot of stress in the ministry, and that stress gets compounded when we wonder, where are the people that once filled our buildings? We have a great church there in Fairfield at New Beginnings with Pastor Corey, who is here with you on Thursday mornings. And we're excited about the things that the Lord is doing. But my heart breaks for the churches that are not moving forward, that are not prospering, that are not doing what they were called to do and what they were designed to do from their founding.
Mm. Yeah, and that statistic just seems like it's just going up faster,
yes.
More and more. And it would be interesting to see some statistics on that. And that way we could offer help to those churches that are struggling out there.
Yeah.
One Cry Fairfield Area Prayer Meeting coming up on the 28th of October. And this is going to be an awesome event, Robert. And your first one was when? Just last month, actually, right? Did you have one in September?
We did at the Fairfield Church of God. We restarted the ministry,
right.
Launching out into the churches, hosting them after taking a short break in the summertime. And so this is how it's going to be moving forward, unless the Lord gives different instruction. We want to be part of what Jesus is looking for when he comes back. The Lord reminded me of the scripture this morning where Jesus told the parable of a widow woman who went to a judge for justice for herself, to avenge a case that she had. He would not hear her, but then he said, because she's wearing me out with her continual and her persistent coming, I'm going to grant her her request. And then Jesus asked the question. This is in Luke chapter 18. In Luke 18:6, Jesus says, "Hear what the unjust judge said, and shall not God avenge his own elect who cry out day and night to him, though he bears long with them? I tell you that he will avenge them speedily." And then Jesus asked this question, and this is the question that drives my ministry. "Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, will he really find faith on the earth?" And that kind of faith, Mark, is the faith that is persistent and persevering in our prayer, in our crying out to God for him to come and bring what only he can do. There are things that humanitarian efforts can do, but there are some things, and our nation is in desperate need of it, there are some things that only a sovereign move of God by his Spirit in the church can do to bring repair to our broken nation.
Amen. Yeah, yeah. Now, if anyone, any churches out there, and you said at the beginning, Robert, there have been a lot of churches that are coming on board with you, but if there's still other churches out there that want to become involved in this,
yes.
How can they do that?
Yeah, I would love to help encourage pastors and churches in starting prayer movements within their own area and their own church, but they can also email me at pastorrobert@nbclife.church. That's all lowercase, one word, pastorrobert@nbclife.church. I will be happy to put you on the list of the reminders of the upcoming meetings and even talk with you, commune with you over a phone call or over lunch or whatever about things that we can do to help you be encouraged for the prayer movement in your own local church.
Yeah, and get a hold of Pastor Robert, and he would be glad to talk to you and give you more information. Now, there's also something there. It's something to do with One Cry that's very important to the ministry itself as
yes.
well, right, Robert?
Yeah. Also, you can see this for yourself on onecry.com. They've come out when they first began this 4 years ago with a declaration of national spiritual emergency, kind of a wake-up call, as it were. And it goes like this: "With heavy hearts, we recognize that the church in America is in a state of spiritual emergency. Like the church is warned in the book of Revelation, we have become lukewarm and compromised, and the light of our witness has grown dim. We confess that despite access to more resources and biblical teaching than any other group of believers in history, we are not characterized by the supernatural power of the Holy Spirit. And we acknowledge our lack of widespread impact for Christ on our lost and disintegrating culture. But God is waking us up from our slumber and mobilizing us to pray earnestly for revival. Together, we desire to travel the narrow road of brokenness, humility, and repentance. In desperation for God, we cry out for the extraordinary work of the Holy Spirit in our day. We believe that true revival is the only hope to reverse our spiritual recession and enable us once again to display the beauty of Jesus Christ and His gospel throughout the world. And because we believe that only Christ can save and heal and revive, we pledge to do three things. We pledge to turn in humble repentance from every sin that God reveals to us. We pledge to pray with urgency for spiritual recovery and awakening. And we pledge to unite with other believers in spreading the hope of Christ-centered revival.
And that can be found on www.onecry.com, right?
That is correct.
That is correct. And again, the Fairfield Area Prayer Meeting, tell us when it's coming up again, Robert. And again, you have a date in November as well,
right? That is correct. On October 28th, Friday next week, we'll be meeting at the Fairfield First General Baptist Church at 1601 West Main Street at 7 p.m. The November meeting will be an interesting combination of the Fairfield Area Ministerial Alliance, for whom I coordinate the National Day of Prayer event and with whom we meet on a monthly basis to bring aid and help and hope to the community of Fairfield. We will be having our annual Thanksgiving celebration at New Beginnings Church on November 21st. We will incorporate the One Cry Prayer Meeting with that annual community Thanksgiving service. We think it's a great combination of worship and prayer there as well. That'll be at New Beginnings Church on November 21st.
And what time? What times do they start on those?
That meeting will start at either 6 or 6:30 p.m. I do not have the time set on that. Ministerial Alliance is working on the final plans for that right now.
Now, let me ask you this. If maybe some of our listeners, they're not able to get to the church, they have no means of transportation, can you come and get them?
We would be thrilled to arrange transportation for anyone that would want to come to any of these meetings. Be happy to do that.
Yeah, and because, you know, there may be some that maybe don't have a car or maybe not able to drive.
Certainly.
And all they have to do is just email you, right?
That's right. Your listeners can also watch for announcements going forward. We'll include those on our Facebook page at New Beginnings Church and also the other group that I mentioned that we pray with on Saturday nights in Sisney called the River of Life, a great group of intercessors there that love God. There's a Facebook page for them as well. We'll make sure those are announced.
Yeah, and we'll also put that on our community and Christian event calendar for you as well.
We appreciate that very much.
So that way you'll be able to follow along and find out when the meetings are.
Yes.
All right. Robert, thanks for coming in this morning. It's been awesome.
Happy to be here.
Anything else you want to remind everyone about on One Cry?
I want our pastors, and I really believe that there's probably a few that are listening to us right now, Mark. I want them to be encouraged that they are not alone. I want you to know, pastors, that we are praying for you on a continual basis. We're lifting you up before the Lord. We have a burden for the work where you do, and we're asking the Lord to increase your ministry and to keep you encouraged in the Lord, and for you to remember that there are people that are asking the Lord to do things that only He can do in your church and in your cities.
Amen. And again, if your church wants to get involved, just get a hold of Pastor Robert at pastorrobert@nbclife.church, right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And again, remember, Friday, October 28th at 7 o'clock at Fairfield First General Baptist Church, the One Cry, the Fairfield Area Prayer Meeting. If your church is not involved, I highly encourage you to get involved.
Amen.
Amen. Robert, thanks for coming in. Keep us posted how things go.
Thank you, Mark.
It's good to see you, my friend.
You too.
All right. Associate Pastor Robert Koker from New Beginnings Church in Fairfield talking about the Fairfield Area Prayer Meeting. and encouraging all churches to get involved. Again, Friday, October 28th, the next one, 7 o'clock, Fairfield First General Baptist Church. Right now it's time for Hope Out Loud with a member of the Barrick family this morning, and it is being underwritten by Monroe County, and they are located in McLeansboro.
Real Life Radio Foundation is blessed by the generosity of Monroe Accounting in McLeansboro. They specialize in a full line of accounting services for businesses, individuals, and farms, including tax preparation, payroll preparation, quarterly sales taxes, and more. Their office is located at 102 East Market Street in downtown McLeansboro, with experience and knowledge to serve your needs. Their phone number is 643-3993. Monroe Accounting in McLeansboro, a proud supporter of 90.9 and 105.5 The Vine.
Today on Hope Out Loud, Andy and Linda Barrick.
Linda, I'm so grateful that you love Jesus more than you love me.
Well, I try to. I found that in order to love my family well, I need to love God more than I love them. Jesus said the first and greatest commandment is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, and the second greatest commandment is to love your neighbor as yourself.
Or, if I can paraphrase C.S. Lewis, when I have learned to love God better than I love my spouse, I shall love my spouse better than I do now.
Let's pray. Dear Jesus, help us to love our family and our friends better by loving you first.
Amen. Learn about the miracle that changed the Barrick family by visiting hopeoutloud.com.
Pointing the way to the truth and the life. Local Christian Radio.
If I rise, let me rise on you. Not on all of my successes, my esteem or my pursuits. If I lose, let me lose my life. 'Cause if I belong to Jesus, the flesh is crucified. For me, Christ, for me to live is Christ, for me to live is Christ, to die is gain. If I grow, let me grow in.
Orchardville Church is presenting the drama Judgment House. This live performance is a walk-through drama which effectively presents the gospel through a relevant and gripping story. Judgment House at Orchardville Church is the last two weekends of October. Dates and times are listed on our website at ochurch.com. Limited spots are available. Please hurry. Tickets are going fast. You can find us on Facebook or email us at tickets@ochurch.com. There is no charge. We look forward to seeing you at Orchardville Church's presentation of Judgment House. Invite your friends and family.
More music and ministry for Fairfield, Benton, and Mount Vernon.
90.9